Good morning, friends. Welcome back to another children's message. My name is Lauren. I am the Children's and Youth Ministries Director at Prince of Peace Lutheran Church in Everett, Washington. And I'm so glad that you could join me this morning. I hope everyone had a really happy and merry Christmas. Today is the day after Christmas, so I hope you enjoyed your festivities with your families. Today's lesson is talking about how we can get so busy that we might lose Jesus. Not good, right? So get a comfy seat, hang out with me for the next few minutes, and let's talk. Have you ever been at some type of big event, like a festival or something, and lost one of your family members in the crowd? It can be kind of scary. Or maybe you're at the grocery store and you just lost your mom in one of the aisles. You didn't realize where she went. Also can be kind of scary. This reminds me of a story about a little boy who got lost while his family was doing some Christmas shopping at the mall. His family was terrified. Why were they scared? They didn't know where he was. They didn't know if someone had taken him or if he had run away. They didn't know if they would be able to find him. All the family members went looking in different directions. And do you know where they found this little boy? He was in the candy shop looking at all the delicious candy. He didn't look lost, and he didn't even know that he was lost. And actually, he was right where they had left him. This story of this little boy reminds me of a time, a story in Jesus' life, a time when Jesus' parents lost him. Crazy, right? Can you imagine losing Jesus? Think about how it wasn't surprising that the little boy in our story was found in a candy shop, not looking scared or worried at all. Now, think about what you know about Jesus. When Jesus was a young boy, his parents took him to Jerusalem for the feast of the Passover. And after the feast was over, Mary and Joseph were traveling back to their hometown when they realized that Jesus was nowhere to be found. When they couldn't find him anywhere, they turned around and went back to the city of Jerusalem to look for him. Where do you think Jesus might have been when his parents lost him? You know where they found him? He was in the temple. Like the little boy in our story previously, Jesus wasn't worried or frightened. He didn't feel afraid or even lost. And when his parents found him, he said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Didn't you know I had to be in my Father's house, the temple?" Now here's a question for you. Do you ever feel like you lose touch with Jesus? I think we all do at some point or another in our lives. Sometimes we get busy, so busy that we stop thinking about Jesus or trying to spend time with him. The good news is we can always find Jesus. Maybe reconnecting with him means stopping for a moment to pray, going to church, make sure we're getting to church on Sunday, reading the Word, taking time to read our Bibles. When we go looking for Jesus, he's always there waiting for us. We'll always be able to find him. So, whenever you feel like you might be losing touch with Jesus, you don't know where he is, just a reminder, you do know where he is and you know exactly where to find him. So, in that spirit, let's pray, reconnect with Jesus a little bit here, and move on. So, fold your hands, close your eyes, and bow your head with me, and let's pray. Dear Jesus, when we lose sight of you, help us to remember that you are still there, always, waiting for us to come back to you. Help us to make you a daily priority. It's in your name that we pray. Amen. All right, guys, before we close out the video, as usual, I've got a coloring page for you. Here's today's coloring page. Jesus in the temple with the elders, chatting it up, talking about scripture, exactly where his parents left him and where he thought that it was obvious that he would be. So you can find this linked in the video description box below and where we post this video on our website, pplc.org. So you can download, print this off, and color that at home if you would like to do that. That is available to you. If you haven't already, don't forget to check out our online virtual worship. You can catch Pastor's sermon on there, and you'll find that on our Facebook page and on our website, pplc.org, where we post this video as well. We post these every Sunday morning, so those of you who are worshiping at home with us have access to that every week as well. I think that's all I've got for you guys. Let's close in prayer together. Fold your hands, close your eyes, and bow your heads with me, and let's pray. Dear God, thank you for sending your son Jesus into the world to be here with us and in our hearts and in our minds. We pray that you help us to remember not to lose sight of Jesus, but when we start to slip, when we start to forget to spend time with him, remind us where he is and that he's always with us and we can always find him. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. All right, guys, that's all I've got for you. Thank you so much for joining me. Merry Christmas. We are now in the season of Christmas, so Merry Christmas. I hope you had a wonderful time celebrating with your families yesterday and the day before that, and continue to during this Christmas season. I will see you next time. Bye.